friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear.
There's not a friend like the Lord in Jesus. Though not born of
she lost her sister Phyllis Schoolcraft. And so Dolores, she actually went to the hospital this past week. They sent her back home. She's just really, really tired. She says, Pastor Tim, I just don't have any energy at all. So Dolores, we pray that the Lord might up the strength to, you know, again, comfort you in the loss of your sister. Again, you see the prayer request from Mom and Dad. Betty Trickett, she is still down at Wellsburg at Valley Haven, or what used to be Valley Haven. She's doing rehab for her hip replacement. She's doing well. In fact, she came down with COVID. No symptoms whatsoever. It's weird. Bucky, I've not talked with Bucky now in, I don't know how long. Do you have an update on Bucky?
He's still the same.
Still the same. Okay. Hank Vincent's probably been a couple weeks since I talked with Hank. Hank was still being able to go to the airport and work some, but Hank's got physical problems. I did talk with Sandra Namath. She seems to be doing well at home. Chuck is still hobbling around, so we'll keep Chuck in prayer. Mary Collins said we could take her name off. She had COVID back apparently in December and seems to be doing well. We rejoice. Chris Chase, boy, oh boy. Chris has also had her life turned upside down. Would you like to give them a short?
December this past year, right around Christmas time, I had my yearly checkup, and they had found uterine cancer. So I had to get a complete hysterectomy done. I was sent to Morgantown to get that done. But at the time of that checkup, going through, I'm fast-forwarding a little bit because there's a lot involved here. They said, well, go ahead and do your mammogram, you know. So I got that done. Well, they found breast cancer in my right breast. So I've been battling both of those. The uterine cancer, we took care of that. It didn't go through the uterine wall. So as I'm recovering from that, they started what we were going to do with the breast. So, of course, they're going to want to remove it. You know, the tumor that I had. I took care of that. They took some lymph nodes, and I'll know Tuesday. I know I have to get at least 16 treatments of radiation. I'm not sure anything else that's going on at this point because, of course, I haven't been back to him for a recheck. During that time in between when it all started up to now, well, a little bit before now, I developed rashes on the outside of both of my breasts that grew quite fast. So he wanted to biopsy those. Those came back. He was looking for another type of breast cancer that it was not. But through this DNA that I had done to see if I carried the trait for breast cancer, because I was going to get a double mastectomy. I'm glad I didn't have that. But in finding, they found that I'm susceptible to melanoma cancer and kidney cancer. So since I developed all that rash that was horrible, very thick, coarse stuff, he's sending me to a dermatologist in April, which will do a full body scan to see about melanoma cancer and other type of skin cancers. Because of it growing so fast and to the point that where it got, he wants me to see him. But it's not the breast cancer that they were looking for, which would have threw me into a double mastectomy. So I thank God for that. I'm healing well from this, but I still don't know what's all entailed till Tuesday. So I'm getting there. I haven't started radiation, nothing like that yet, but I'll know more on Tuesday for that.
So her life has definitely been turned upside down. And with her job, I appreciate the church giving me the freedom to go and do stuff. Her job, much of this time, yeah, you've had to continue to work and just making bills paid. And
I haven't been to work since the 9th of January.
Okay.
And,
okay.
But my boss is a wonderful boss. You know, he's compensating me somewhat. He doesn't need to, but that's the way.
Praise the Lord.
That's the way my boss is.
Praise
they're
the
all
Lord.
Sticking in there for me, so I'm partially there.
Okay.
I'm getting there.
Chris, our prayers are with you.
Thank you.
And her mom is over at Brightwood, and she's doing well.
She's doing pretty good. Yeah.
Other names, Dorothy Schaefer, she had some congestive heart failure. I've not talked with Dave and Linda, but I'm taking that's okay, praying that she's okay. They watch us on video, And so do keep Dorothy Schaefer. She's still down in Florida. Marie John, I've not heard anything. If anybody has an update, let me know. Austin Crow, this is a state trooper the other night. It's related to friends of whatnot of the Utzes. I can't remember the exact ties, but anyhow, he's a state trooper, had pulled somebody over, car came along and hit them. He was in danger of losing his leg. So he's going to have serious injuries to overcome. Arky Snyder, this is Miss Bessie's brother. He's got some kidney issues.
Liver.
It's liver, okay. And then Diane Snyder, that's a sister-in-law. She's got some heart issues. So I wrote down the wrong organ, liver, okay. So let me give you some additional names. Darlene Kemp, next door to the church, she has literally been coughing nonstop for 3 months. It is horrendous. She's been to doctor after doctor, been through, I think, 3 doses of the Teflon pearls, hasn't done anything. If you give her a call and she starts to say anything, she just starts coughing just uncontrollably. She really needs our prayers. I don't see how she survived that because it goes on 24 hours a day. Donnie Jackson, keep him in prayer Tuesday. He's going to have back surgery. He had gone down to Florida and got a chance to visit with his brother, play some golf about 12 days down there. His back went out on him. He actually had to come back up here. They took him to the airport in a wheelchair. So Donnie's back is not good, but he's going to have surgery on Tuesday. Wanda Cook, a friend of Sheila's. Wanda has been sent home with hospice. She needs our prayers. Rich Williams, this is a son-in-law, I think, of a lady that I know. He's got cancer, and they're trying to treat it, so pray that it goes well. A good friend of mine, Brian Lindenmuth, he has an uncle, Jeff Lindenmuth, that has pancreatic cancer. We have Tasha Kamp, K-A-M-P-E. She has cancer, and this is a relationship to you, Miss Bessie.
She's my niece.
Niece, okay. And she may be only like 30 years of age. And then a friend of April's, Amy Hartline, kind of a good news, bad news situation. She's got some good news.
She's been having trouble breathing. They thought she needed a heart cath. She had a heart cath done Friday. They didn't find any blockages. So it's not her heart, but they still don't know what it could be.
Okay.
They're still exploring options.
So Amy is really having some problems breathing. And so those are the ones that I have. And if I've overlooked anybody, if you have names that you want to put back on, please do so. Yes?
Jim, we want to thank everyone for the prayers that we went through.
Still need the prayers. Clyde and Janet, of course, lost their son-in-law a little over a month ago. Joe Pugh was 50 years of age. He'd had surgery on a Friday. The surgery went well. It took about an hour and a half. Saturday, they were discharging him from Weirton Medical. He had talked with his wife. She was on the way back from Pittsburgh to pick him up. And he just collapsed on the bed. Somebody was walking past the room, noticed it, contacted the people there on the floor. They tried for half an hour to resuscitate him and were unable to. And it's absolutely turned their lives upside down as well. Joe leaves behind his wife, Angie, of 29 years, and 2 children, Vince and Amanda. And their lives have just been turned upside down. Our prayers go out to you.
Thanks.
We love y'all. So much heartache around, folks. And we do what we can to encourage each other. Because life is tough. Life is tough. Is there anything we could do for y'all? Or?
No.
Other than just pray and encourage you.
Yeah.
And one other prayer request that y'all are very much aware of, the Ukraine situation, those poor people there. And then I understand from news reports that China is maybe on the verge of doing military exercises against Taiwan. And I told them in Sunday school, when I mentioned other people, this reminds me of Matthew chapter 24 that Jesus says in the last days, going to be wars and rumors of wars, nations going to rise against nation. And I can't say for sure that this is the end times, but I tell you what, folks, when you look at what's going on around the world, it really makes me think that we could be moving into the last days. So,
job situation.
The job situation. Robin has a brother, Raymond, that lost his job. My brother, Bert, is losing his job at the Coke plant. So, absolutely. Any others? Okay. Let's pray together. Father, in some ways I almost feel guilty as I start this prayer because we've spent a lot of time talking about the needs. And it's not that I don't want to go back through them all to you. We know that you've been listening. Father, you've been aware of these needs even before we were aware of them. But I feel guilty, Father, because I don't plan on going back through them individually. I just want to say, along with our congregation, Father, we are concerned about each of these situations. And we know that you've asked us to pray, to call out to you. Father, in most of these cases, if not all of them, there's nothing we can do. The situations are out of our control. They're in your hands. Whether it's a healing, whether it's getting treatments that, Lord, you're going to use to help the person get better, whether it's providing jobs, Father, whatever the need is, I think that this is why you told us to pray, because you want us to understand. We can't. We can't do what's needed to be done, but you can. Father, we come to you and we say, Lord, we need your help. And we just ask for your blessing to be upon each one of these people, that during their time of need, they might experience your strength present with them. May they experience your healing touch. May they experience your comfort. May they experience the hope and the peace that you offer regardless of what happens, that, Father, you say to us, don't worry, it's going to be okay. Father, we come to you at this time, and as I said, I feel guilty because I don't plan to go back through all of them individually. But we present these needs to you and ask, Father, your blessing upon each person. We pray that you'll meet our needs as well. We pray that you will keep us close by you and encourage us to keep the faith, never to doubt you. We say it all the time. Your God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. It's not just a slogan. It's truth. You are good. People might say, well, how can you say God is good in the midst of pain and suffering and trouble and difficulty? Father, we know that you are in control. And it doesn't matter what the circumstances are. You are still in control, and if you've allowed it, it's only because you have a purpose. Father, we pray that you might never allow us to doubt you, but help us to always continue to believe truth. And the truth is, you are good all the time, and all the time you are good. Father, we pray that you might meet unspoken needs, those things that maybe we don't open up and tell others about, that, Lord, you would meet those needs as well. And in every situation, both the spoken and the unspoken, may your name be praised. Father, because it's you, it's your hand at work. It's you that makes the difference. And Father, we need to celebrate how good you are and how good you've been, and celebrate how good you're going to be. Lord, we come into your house this morning and just ask that you might meet these needs. Pray for our leaders, that you'll give them wisdom. We pray, Father, for revival, that people might turn back to you. Your people turn back to you. We pray for those that are lost, that, Lord, you'll speak to their hearts and help them to recognize they need to get saved. There's no guarantee that tomorrow is going to come for them. I pray, Father, that you'll be with our military and our law enforcement, that you'll protect them. We also pray, Father, that your kingdom might come. We pray that your will might be done here on earth, just like it's done in heaven. Father, we love you. We thank you for giving us this time together. We thank you for hearing our prayers. We ask now your continued blessing upon the remainder of the service, that you might use it to speak to our hearts, to help us to become more like your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen.